Dr. Kanji Murangi says UNAM has pumped into the market thousands of graduates, sufficient to contribute to nation building and its well-being. Graduates in natural science are expected to explore and discover, while engineers are critical to attain the infrastructure development for Namibia.
For us as government, your graduation today is actually a testimony to the fact that the government's National Human Resource Development Program is being fulfilled in different areas that are needed by our economy.
The minister says it is gratifying to note the increase in students studying in various study fields at the northern campuses. Students in the field of engineering increased from 30 in 2009 to over 820 in 2024, with female engineering students increased from 22% in 2012 to 32% this year. International students constitute 10% of the engineering student population. 552 students, including PhDs and master's degree, have graduated in the field of engineering since its establishment 15 years ago. She called on graduates to go out into the competitive world of work and demonstrate their professional capabilities and show positive change. UNAM's Vice Chancellor, Professor Kenneth Matengu, called on the graduates to go out and look for work and not for a job.
Jobs are the things we do for payment, for remuneration. They are not always productive, but work is that which we do, that which we human beings do productively to meet human needs.
We spoke to some of the graduates.
Disability is not inability. So you must use what you have, what is remaining. So some of the people, they have sustained that high injury that they cannot do anything. But for me, my brain, or let me say my mind, is fine. It's not affected by the injury. So I decided to take this initiative of studying.
I'm an LLB honors graduate, and I would like to encourage everyone to never give up on their dreams. And I would also like to encourage all the LLB graduates not to only focus on civil and criminal proceedings, but to also engage in mining, human rights, and environmental law.
Tunatenia Imbodi, NBC News, Ongwediva.